Today we will be doing an experiment to find the focal length of a concave mirror by plotting graphs between u and v or between 1 by u and 1 by v. Apparatus needed: a concave mirror of small focal length, 3 uprights, 2 needles, optical bench, meter scale, mirror stand and a screen. Apparatus needed: an optical bench, 3 uprights. You have a mirror holder, 2 needles. The 2 needles and this mirror holder has to be inserted into these uprights. You have a mirror, a half meter scale. You have a mirror stand and a screen. Theory: focal length of a concave mirror is calculated by using the formula 1 by f is equal to 1 by v plus 1 by u, or f is equal to uv divided by u plus v. Approximate focal length of concave mirror can be found by using a distant object. The image of a distant object is formed at the focus of a concave mirror. This is a diagrammatic representation for finding the focal length of a concave mirror. You have to find the rough focal length of a given concave mirror. For this you have to use the distant object method. So I try to focus a distant object on the white screen. For this you can move the mirror towards the screen, and here you can see a sharp image is obtained at a distance of approximately 15 cm. That means the distance between the screen and the mirror is 15 cm. So the rough focal length here of the given concave mirror is 15 cm. After finding the rough focal length of the concave mirror, you can place the mirror in the mirror holder, fixed in the upright, and place it in a reading approximately coinciding zero marking. So you can see here in the optical bench it is zero marking. The rough focal length of the concave mirror was found to be 15 cm. So you have to keep an object which this upright serves as an object. So this upright along with this needle serves as an object, and this has to be kept at a distance of twice the focal length. That means at C, that is around 30 cm. Now you have to view from this side and locate the position of the image through the mirror, and here you can see an inverted image of the needle, this needle, in the mirror, and check for a parallax error. Here I can see when I shift my head to the either positions, the tip of this upright, the object upright, and the tip of the needle that is seen as the image through the concave mirror doesn't coincide, and there is a relative shift between them, which means that there is a parallax error. In the next step, this parallax error has to be removed. So you can see here, there is a relative shift between the tip of the image needle and the tip of the object needle, which shows that there is a parallax error. By making the lateral adjustments, see that the tip of the image needle seen through the concave mirror and tip of this upright coincides with each other, and there is no relative shift between them. So by making a lateral adjustments, I can see that there is no relative shift between them. That means the parallax has been removed. Here you can see that the mirror is kept at a marking of 0, while the object was placed at C, which was 30 cm. Now you have to keep the object at a distance between the pole of the mirror and the center of curvature. That means I will shift the object within the limits of the radius of curvature. So I can move it to, say, example here, 27 centimeter. That means now the object is kept at 27 centimeter. Keep a third upright on the optical bench and see that the tip of this upright, the third upright, should coincide with the tip of the image needle that you see in the concave mirror. For this, you have to slightly move it to and fro here towards the front and slightly backwards to see that the exact position is achieved and the parallax error is removed. For that, you can make the lateral adjustments. Now at this point, we can see that the parallax error has been removed and the tip of the image needle seen through the concave mirror and the tip of the third upright here, this one, actually are in the same position, which means all the three are in the same straight line. When the parallax was removed here, this upright is coinciding at a point of 35 centimeter. So now you can see that the distance between the mirror and this will serve as the object. Meanwhile, the distance between the mirror and this upright will serve as the image distance. So from here to here is the object distance represented by U, and from here, the center of the mirror, and to this upright will give you the image distance, which is represented by V. So here you could see that the object distance was minus 27 centimeter and the image distance was minus 35 centimeter. Repeat the procedure for 6 more readings. Now you can shift the object position by 1 centimeter and keep the object distance as 26 centimeter, and similarly repeat the same procedure by removing the parallax, find the image distance. Observations: the approximate focal length of the concave mirror was found to be 15 centimeter. The object needle O centimeter, concave mirror P centimeter, image needle I dash centimeter, OP is equal to U centimeter, OI is equal to V centimeter. For 27, when the object was placed at O, that it was 27 centimeter, the concave mirror was placed at 0 centimeter, the image was formed at 35 centimeter. Applying sign conventions, OP becomes minus 27 and OI dash becomes minus 35. Calculate the reciprocal of U, that is 1 by U, you get 0.0370. Calculate the reciprocal of V, you get 1 by V is equal to 0.0285. And apply the focal length formula for a concave mirror, that is UV divided by U plus V, you get 15.24. Similarly, carry out the procedures and record your observations for 5 more observations. Calculate the mean F. F1 is equal to F2 plus F3 plus F4 plus F5 plus F6 divided by 6. So it is 15.24 plus 15.18 plus 15.07 plus 15.75 plus 15.10 plus 15.20 divided by 6 is equal to 91.54 divided by 6 is equal to 15.25 centimeter. The model graph between U and V, which is a rectangular hyperbola, a graph between 1 by U and 1 by V, it is a straight line. The graphs have been plotted here. You can see here at 45 degree it bisects the curve. So here you get F is equal to OA plus OB divided by 4. So OA is minus 30 plus OB is minus 32.5 by 4, is equal to minus 62.5 divided by 4. So by a UV graph you get a focal length of 15.6 cm. This is a graph between 1 by U and 1 by V. You can see here the straight line equally intersects the x-axis and the y-axis. So F is equal to 2 divided by OA plus OB is equal to 2 divided by 0.065 plus 0.064, which will give you an answer of 15.5 cm. Result: focal length of concave mirror by UV method is minus 15.25 cm. By UV graph it's minus 15.6 cm. By 1 by U and 1 by V graph is minus 15.5 cm.